it's dangerous out there. You know, the falling ice, my personal experience is I had a big chunk come down and hit my truck and scared the living bejesus out of me. You know, it's scary. And seeing all these big ice chunks come down, and it could hurt somebody really bad, if not kill them. You know, I mean, we have spears that come off of those suspender cables, and it's just like a spear coming down to the roadbed. And just imagine what that would do to your car. We see it all the time. It comes down and it'll crush you. It'll kill you. I mean, people don't see that. You know, they'll see a nice, beautiful day out, sunny out. Why is the bridge closed? Falling ice.
In the case of falling ice, it is so dangerous that it's like it's cut and dry that we have to close the bridge because it is so dangerous. That is our main reason, is safety, because you can't have people driving along with these brick-like pieces of ice falling from the sky randomly. Everybody's familiar with icicles forming, and if you are wanting to knock the icicles out, you're not going to want to stand underneath that. Nobody would want to do that. And when big hailstorms come, when you get large size hail, they tell you to take shelter. So it's very similar to ice dropping off randomly from the bridge. So we have had our maintenance vehicles damaged by falling ice. We had roofs caved in on our pickup trucks, windshields broken, and the drivers were very scared when that happened, obviously. Fortunately, they haven't been injured. We haven't had any injuries resulting from the falling ice, and we for sure want to keep it that way. We know it's a big inconvenience, and we absolutely hate to close the bridge. We only do it in extreme situations, for crashes and for ice falling and for high winds, things like that. And so we absolutely hate to do that to our traveling public. And we're fortunate that the communities have come to the aid of the traveling public and opening different areas where they can get food and shelter and restrooms. So that is good. But we do know that it's a big inconvenience for our patrons.
It's easy to stay informed on the current bridge conditions. Check on our website, MackinacBridge.org, or follow us on Twitter @MackinacBridge for the latest news about travel conditions.